Hello and welcome back to Shadowrun Hong Kong. My name is Syken and we're playing Hard Mode. We are continuing our adventure of Sparklight, the human rigger. Last time we found out who finally kidnapped our father, Raymond. It was his own mother, so kind of our grandmother in a sense, who also wants to kill us. Pretty messed up family dynamics, right? So we decided to free him, and this is exactly the run that we're now going to do. Unfortunately, I couldn't upgrade all of the drones, so we're playing with one S-class drone, a Doberman, and one B-class drone. We're taking the same crew as per usual, Gaichu, Gobbet, and Isobel. And I'm pretty happy how the build overall played out. Sparklight has 10 armor now and is really a decent street samurai plus a very, very good rigger. Good, and here we go. We are heading to MTR South Island Line, a mega corporation in Hong Kong. Unfortunately, we still can't use the sniper laser sniping rifle. Once we get our drones in a row, that is the next loot that we're going to use. Definitely want to use the prototype. Good. This run is not going to be easy. We are probably going to face a rather massive opposition. And I remember that the decking part wasn't easy as well. So here we go. We came through the delivery entrance. Using our forged ID to get into the building. So far, so good. Good. I think we need to dress up in order to get into the next rooms. I think this here was security. Yeah, that's the security area. We might not want to trigger that right away. Instead, let's get some overalls. There we go. And that would be 2627. Putting on a uniform will make us less likely to stick out. But make no mistake, we are going to need to fight our way out sooner or later. One extra karma. Are they opening the door? No. Okay, we'll get through that eventually. Good. Our delivery fake ID has absolutely worked. Fantastic. And I think that was it. We're going to come back to this area later. Much later. Let's start with sales and acquisition. Yeah, I'm missing the high charisma. Okay. We don't have an appointment. Last time I could just talk my way out of it, which was easy enough. We'll eventually get an appointment. Or just start attacking everyone. Either way works. Well, they knew the passes were stolen. Effort. So much for our disguise. I was really trying to not start a fight right away. But what am I supposed to do? All right, we're hasting Gaichu. Syken here begins to reflex trigger. And we got the new drone that I definitely would like to try out. The Wolfhound here has quite a few grenades, actually. So what are we looking at? Smoke reduces hit chance. Flashbang grenade. Lots and lots of flashbang grenades. Yep, that is gonna be great. There we go. Both of them simply taken out. And look at that, we now do have three action points. This guy has lost his cover, which means our drone can easily pick him up. It's a bit too close for the sniper drone. Elsewise, we would be fine. Isabel takes matters into her own hands. Holy shit, that's a lot of damage. And Sparklight helps killing that enforcer. That's where the reinforcements come into play. There we go. He dropped the security pass, by the way. But now it's too late. I mean, the grenade explosions are clearly audible. There we go. Security pass added. We're going to put on some defense and just get into cover. Next up, Overwatch. And we haven't even received damage yet, so everyone puts themselves in cover in Overwatches. And that is what happens when you are overwatching and someone just runs into it. Okay, I guess these guys here are civilians. Which leaves us with one person that has entered. Might as well overwatch his sword. We're overwatching Sparklight. Let's give the Wolfhound some more accuracy, and I would like to overwatch with the Uzi. We're going to overwatch with the pistol. We're reloading our grenade launcher with our new drone. Overwatching that as well. Matter of fact, we're overwatching with every single unit that we do have. We have two people that can throw back grenades. Cut the alarm in the security matrix. Yeah, well, we would do that. But we're kind of busy here. Increasing the accuracy of Isabel. Sparklight gets some haste, and Isabel starts raining grenades. It's one hit. Two hits, ouch. We gotta heal Gaichu. He can start healing himself thanks to Regenerate, the new ability that we have taken. Sparklight supports him. Full auto. And another full auto. Unfortunately, we are not hitting many shots. That is indeed unfortunate. Sniper drone tries to finish the guard. And there we are. Overwatch. And our new support drone overwatches as well. Oh, we're being attacked from behind. Interesting. Well, look who just got here. Good, this guy needs to die. Fortunately, we're hitting like really bad. Wow. It's a 60% chance to hit, and we're missing every single hit. Okay, that brings us to our shaman. We're healing Gaichu. Haven't taken a single point of damage yet. But it appears we can't hit for shit, and our sniper drone isn't really good in close combat shots. Kaichu gets some extra accuracy, and we're finishing the guard. Nope, this one is an elusive one. But he finally goes down. And I misclicked. Unfortunately, did not hit him. There we go, that's what I'm talking about. I mean, the drone has a 60% hit chance, but it feels more like a 20% hit chance. Okay. So, are these unlimited reinforcements? I'm not even sure. I certainly did not have the same problem the last time. Yeah, we gotta do something. Can't just stand here. Where do we cut the alarm off the security matrix? Wow, down there. Okay, that's not practical. We can't just go there. Isabel opens the door. And starts moving in. Our drone heals itself. Let's see if we can kill this guy before the next wave appears. Apparently they are now coming from here. There we go. Nice little damage. Good. Kaichu is still the most reliable form of damage in those close quarter combats. Massive amount of damage coming in. Good. Who could we heal? Yeah, Gaichu could take a healing. That's good. The Wolfhound certainly can take a healing as well. By the way, when the drone hits, it hits pretty hard. 20 points of damage. That's nothing to sneeze at. All right, continuing our movement. And it indeed seems that they continue spawning here. Okay. And it seems that more and more of them are spawning, so we gotta hurry, luckily for us. They brought an elemental. Good. We got to move Gaichu at least partially out of the way here. Regaining some armor. One. Two. And then get out of the way. Because now it's fireball time. There we go. That worked like a charm. Yeah, I don't want to stand in the open or putting ourselves in cover. Good, time for our drone to shine. How about we're using a big fat stun grenade? There we go. Everyone is stunned, unfortunately, including Sparklight. So I'm surprised that we can even act. Holy shit. Yeah, Sparklight is stunned, so that's a problem. Which means our drones cannot be operated for one round, but since everyone else cannot act either, that's not even a problem. Wow, the damage is incredible. 20 plus damage every single hit. Yeah, and I think we weren't supposed to, like, completely knock out the guards. I remember the last time that I actually went in before everything happened. So it was a long, drawn-out fight. This time it's a bit more relaxed. I'm, by the way, really happy about the Doberman. Well, that run starts interesting. We're directly drawing attention. That's not how you want to start a run. God damn it, I'm so bad. You can see the host has 360 trays, so we don't want to screw it up in the beginning because the enemies here are indeed quite strong. There we go. A couple of them have already shown up. So let's summon our programs. That's unfortunate. 81% shot missed. Yeah, they are increasing the system trays, but I think we're going to be fine. I just need to deal with them. Healing ourselves. Let's try to hit the ice. Didn't work out as intended. Taking cover. There we go, one down. Yeah, it's annoying when they have full cover. I definitely need to get there and get them out of their cover, and we need to kill the Watcher. All right, if we deck out, yeah, that's fine. It's okay. We can heal her wound in the next combat. And I don't want to continue the fight without the assassin program. Plus, it would have simply generated more distress in the system. Good. The Watchers that we have already killed will remain killed. Starting our countermeasure programs, and let's buff up the assassin. God damn it, another 70% shot that we missed. Yeah, this is a really poor position. If we go for full cover, we're increasing the trace. And by the way, using our anti-trace on cooldown, that means our combat abilities will be a bit weaker for that one round. But at least we're not overloading the system as fast. We need to do quite a few things here in the matrix, and I want to make sure that we're not triggering the alarm. Wonderful. Gotta heal ourselves. Accuracy, buff, and let's kill these guys. Oh, thank you, finally. Yeah, I could move up here, but that would again put us at risk of being detected. There we go. Damage over time. Perfect. I've chosen the wrong side. I hoped that I could slip through on the lower part, but I couldn't. So we're back to 100 trays, which is unfortunate. I was hoping that we can do it much smoother. I'll hack this one, but I will cut it out of the video stream. I don't think that that's super interesting. All right, security node is hacked. I'm not 100% sure, but I think we got access to floor 49. I think there was not anything up here. No, there wasn't. Okay, so that's number one. System is still a bit larger than that. Summoning our programs, and I think it's appropriate to heal ourselves. Very good. This here's black eyes, so it deals real damage to Isabel. Wow, and we're being crit for 105. That is unfortunate. All right, can't heal ourselves, so... let's stand and fight. Black Eyes definitely needs to die first. There we go. Next up, we gotta deal with those white ice enemies. Yep. And if possible, I'd like to heal ourselves, so one more round of kind of holding him at bay wouldn't be too bad. And to not take too much more damage, let's position ourselves in full cover. We're at 155 security rating. And we're still being hit, unfortunately. Perfect. That is an important data storage. Again, I'm going to hack it instead of forcing it open. And there we go. Good. Some company has increased its security measure. Company-wide security protocols will double. And we now got Raymond's location, which is good. God damn it, I thought I was safe. But I wasn't. Good. Checking out. And let's take a look at the overall situation here. So we got a keypad, which I think Yeah, what's that one? Perfect. Great. So, oh, wonderful. That's a that's worth a lot of money. Even better, that's worth 2,000. A Stay Orc. That is perfect. Really good weapons now. Great. That was definitely worth it. I think overall room was probably 3,000 Nguyen, maybe even more. Oh, I remember this one here. Last time they summoned something and I basically broke into the lab and completely let it loose. It was a ghost, which basically then ran it down and killed, or at least distracted the people here. Strip armor, yes please. And focus life. Those two have helped me a lot the last time that I played. On the mage run, I definitely used them. I was super happy to find them here. A bit unfortunate that it was on the quote-unquote one of the last missions. But yeah, definitely a lot of money that we would be getting. Let's clear out the rest here. We got some archives and machine operation. Blocking the way for Isabel so that the Black Ice is not hurting Isabel directly. Session program starts and deals critical damage. We might even be able to one-shot this guy. Yep, there we go. I'm going to do that off screen again. There we go. Read the mails towards the special projects. And it seems that the Tsang family wanted to build something really, really special in the district that was so off. They wanted to build a machine there, and more of that to come soon. And there we go. Mission added, block IC password for assist maintenance. Okay, good. So we're done with that mainframe here. Got ourselves our loot as well. Did I forget anything? Yeah, that is where I opened the shutters the last time, and that is the monster. That's the monster we released the last time. It's nice, we still get the karma. And yeah, it moved right there and messed up everything on its way. Good. So, 40 minutes in, we've cleared this floor. There's definitely more to come. And I think this here is a good point to end today's episode. This time I'll not do a full run and then splice it, but rather end the episode regularly. We already got 5 karma, so we're definitely going to get a lot of karma once this is over. And we got ourselves very nice cash loot, enough to probably afford the other drone. And if we're really, really lucky and find some more cash loot, we might as well be able to afford that second cyber limb that we were looking for. Thank you for watching, guys, and we're going to continue here in the next run. Bye-bye.